In this Cakewalk tutorial, we're looking at how to use EZDrummer 2 in Cakewalk properly. Now, sure, you could just add it to an instrument track and have all of those drums come out of one track, but there is a better way to do it, and in this video, we're looking at how. I'm Zane, welcome to Audio Tech TV, where it's my goal to help you conquer the tech so you can unleash your creative beast. And if you aren't sure what EZDrummer 2 is, it's basically a drum plugin that makes it very easy to add professional sounding drums to your tracks, and it's fairly affordable for what you get with it. Now, I'm going to have a full kind of review of that plugin, and be sure to subscribe in case you want to check that out if you aren't subscribed already. Now let's look at setting up EZDrummer 2 in Cakewalk. All right, so I'm starting with a new project, and a new project on your computer should look something like this. If you don't have this sidebar open, it probably looks something like this. So you could just click this arrow here and expand this area. And then what we're going to do is click on this piano looking icon right here and type in EZDrummer, and it should just, there it is, pops up there, and we want to drag it over into this area, then let go. And now this has created an instrument track with EZDrummer on it. So if we click here, we'll be able to see the EZDrummer interface. And for this, I'm just going to use whatever the default drum kit is with EZDrummer. So if you look and we play this, all of our drums are coming out of just this one track, which can be useful if you just want to throw in a quick drum beat to play along to or something like that. But if you're recording and you want to get a decent drum sound, you're going to want these drums to come out of their own track, so you can put different effects onto each drum and overheads and that sort of thing. And that's what we're looking at now. So you can close down this sidebar, because it's kind of in the way now. Just click those arrows. And you can even close down the Pro Channel strip over there. And it should look something like this. Now, if you're using a different kit or even different preset than this default one, you want to make sure you go in here, because it's likely going to be slightly different in this area, which is what we're going to get to in this next part. But before we get there, we want to go up to Insert. And then we want to go to Stereo Bus. Click that. Looks like nothing happened, but something did happen. Let's go up to Views, Console View, and you can see we have this Bus D, and that's the stereo bus that we just created. So if you double click in there, we can rename that. I'm just going to call it Drum Bus. All right, so now that that's created, we can close down our console view. And now we want to count how many channels there are in our mixer here in the EZDrummer plugin. So there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. 12 channels in there. So let's go up to Insert. And now we want to go to Multiple Tracks. And in Track Count, we want to put in 12. Main Destination is going to be that drum bus that we just created. So be sure to change that. And then down here in the MIDI section, we want to change that to 0 because we don't need any MIDI tracks. Now click OK. And you can see it's created all of these tracks for us here. So now we got to go through this one by one with each of these channels. But at least our outputs are all set and we don't have to worry about that on each channel. Now, one thing to note before we get into this next step is you'll see some of these channels are mono. They just have the one VU meter strip here, and some are stereo. So we want to pay attention to this while we're setting up the inputs for all of these tracks, because there's stereo inputs and mono inputs. So be sure when you do one, you look to see if it's mono or stereo. So first, we have our kick. So let's name this track kick. And then we want to expand it a bit by clicking these arrows. And right here where it says none, let's click that, go to EZDrummer. And then here we see on this side, it says EZ1, and there's three options. So for a mono track, you want EZ1, the 1L, or whatever track you're doing, you want the left of that. So the L stands for left, Let's click on that. Now when we play the drums, so the kick drum now comes out of there. And what I'm going to do just quickly is I'm going to bring up this console view. And I want to go to my main EZDrummer track. That's this one here. And I'm going to bring the volume all the way down, because we don't want any volume coming out of that. We just want volume coming out of these other tracks here. I'll close down console again. And we'll move on to the next drum, which is our snare. Now, one thing to note, I didn't have to change the output here because it's already set to one. They're all set to one. But if I wanted to, I could have set the output to some other channel. But I'm just going to leave it at one for the kick. And then we're going to go to snare now. So let's name this one to snare. And then we're going to set the input to EZDrummer 2 3L. So that's 2. And now when we go here, play the snare. And you can see there's a little bit of bleed going into the kick drum, just like if you were to mic up an actual drum kit, you would get that bleed as well. So if we mute that, you can hear that bleed coming through the kick drum mic. And same thing, you can hear the kick drum coming through the snare mic. That is fine. We're just going to move along here. So we've got, next one is hi-hat. Now I usually skip over hi-hat and do it after this next one. I like to keep my drums together. So I'm going to put toms as the actual next one here. Toms. So toms is going to be 3. And we're going to change the input to EZDrummer. And you'll notice that toms is a stereo output. So we're going to change this to 3, but stereo. So that's the S at the end for stereo. And let's just make sure it works. And there are our toms on that channel. And just go through and do the same thing for all of those. All right, so we have all of this set up. And again, like I said earlier, depending on what drum kit you have, this could change. So you can't use this as a template for all of the kits in EZDrummer. But now that you know how to do this, it's pretty easy to set up. And what I recommend doing is maybe saving this as a project, but also saving it as a template so you can easily load it up next time. Say I wanted to load up my EZDrummer 2 Modern Basic Kit and I want it all set up, I could just go into my templates and load that as a template, and it's going to be all set up. So I don't have to do this every time for that kit. So whatever kit you use most often, be sure to save this as a template and as a project, just in case. That's sort of like a backup thing. If something were to happen to the template, you would at least have that project as well. All right, so now that we have this all set up, where do we bring our MIDIs for this? So you can just drag your MIDI, whatever one you want. We'll drag this one onto that main EZDrummer track right here. So I'll put that there. We'll play it back. And you can see the EZDrummer has no volume coming out of it. So we're not hearing anything out of that main track. All we're hearing is these separate tracks going to our drum bus over here. So yeah, you put your MIDI on that main EZDrummer track and build your song that way. And now you can easily go into kick and add any effects you want just to the kick drum. So we'll go to audio effects. And I know one that I always use on the kick is the DBX 160. So you put that on there. Let's go to one of these presets for now. And kick drum. And you can hear now I have full control over this kit. I can make this kick more punchy. I can make the snare however I want and any of these tracks however I want. And then I have a drum bus at the end where I can glue it all together, maybe with a bus compressor and some EQ or whatever I want to put on that drum bus. Now, if you want to check out even more Cakewalk tutorials, click the video on the screen right now or click the one under it to see what YouTube recommends. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. Also, subscribe to the channel for more videos like this. Thank you so much for watching. For Audio Tech TV, I'm Zane. Keep creating, and we'll talk soon.